We all have a friend that tends to be ahead of the crowd. They ooze that coolness. Now I'm going to show you some plants that have the qualities of a hipster. Now this plant here is so mainstream, it doesn't even know it's cool. Now, iceberg lettuce was the only lettuce that you could buy in the greengrocer many years ago, and that's because it actually transported very well. Iceberg lettuce can be grown pretty much all year round, but it does prefer the cooler months. If you are planting in summer, plant them near your tall crops such as corn and runner beans, and this should provide them with a bit of shade. The Boston fern has had a recent comeback after being a popular houseplant in the 70s. This plant originates from the tropics, making it an ideal plant indoors. I know we've got it outside at the moment, but this plant actually likes humid conditions, making it perfect for the bathroom. Now you might find that the leaves will start to turn yellow, and that's caused by a lack of humidity. To resolve that, grab a water sprayer, give it the occasional spray, and that should do it. Overall, a great plant to be using in your homemade macrame that you learn to make on YouTube. And if you fail like me, you get a friend to make it. Now, it's called the fruit salad plant. That's because the fruit of this plant actually tastes like you're eating a range of different types of fruit altogether. However, it very rarely happens when grown indoors. It is a climbing plant that can grow quite large, making it ideal for large rooms. If brewing beer is trendy, then hops must be the ultimate hipster acquisition. Hops can actually become quite weedy and they like lots of water. When I was living in Italy, I'd ride along the waterways and actually grab a handful to use to garnish my beer in the evenings. But hey, let's ask the expert on how we can best use these hops to brew our beer. We're at the public brewery in Croydon and I'm talking to Brendan, the head brewer, to find out more about hops. We've picked a couple of hops here. Obviously, these are a bit more mature. Can you explain a little bit about these?
Yeah, sure. So we've got a few different varieties that we're growing out the back of the brewery here. So they're all developing at different stages there. So starting with these guys here, these are quite immature hop flowers. So you can see they're quite feathery and sort of spiky. And we really want them to look like these little guys here. So they're a lot fatter. They're really leafy and coney and that sort of thing. But there's really a couple of things that we're looking for with that. So I've sort of broken one apart in there. And you can see that there's all this sort of nice yellow powder in there. And that's what we call lupulin. That's the good stuff.
So in terms of the beer process, what do hops actually do to beer?
We use hops for three main purposes: bittering, flavour and aroma in beer.
Sounds good, but I think I'll leave the brewing to you. I'm getting pretty thirsty, mate.
So, me too.
Thanks, mate. Thank you very much for your time.
Thanks.
Cheers.